This was the summer of 2014, 50 days of non-stop shelling, mostly on the southern part of Israel. Over 3,000 rockets were fired, thousands of residents left their homes with their families and children and moved north. Five civilians were killed, over 1,600 wounded. You can only imagine the devastating effect on businesses.
The average was 2 to 3 times going to the shelters in the middle of the day.
It was very, very hot. I didn't sleep all night because of the noises.
מעל חודש וחצי, האוטובוסים היו סגורים. הנהגים היו בבית.
לא הרשו לחקלאים להגיע לאדמות שלהם ולאבד אותם. חקלאים שהאדמות שלהם הפכו לשטחי כינוס, שטחים צבאיים סגורים.
Life must go on, but how do you come back after 50 days of war?
About 10 years ago, the situation of missiles falling in Sderot started, and there was no professional therapist who were willing to work at that time in Sderot.
Tal spent most of this time helping the kids of Sderot. As a social worker, she tried to calm their fears and deal with their emotional trauma. But that's also part of her business.
When I started to work with them, I felt that I don't have enough tools. I sat at home, very frustrated, and thinking, what can help me to build trust fast with them? And I thought about game. And that's the first game started. I made it by hand, the first game. I came into the class and I showed them the game, and I was amazed by how joyful it was. And I, that moment, I understood that I have a key.
Tal developed emotional games for children, simple yet effective. Let the kids play to overcome their anxieties.
I really started everything from nothing. And about 4 or 5 years ago, the business started to pick up, and I needed the finance in order to grow, and Koret helped me to make it happen. The money helped me to hire more people and make a massive production.
She helped thousands of kids all over Israel thanks to Koret's financing, and now she has ambitious plans.
In my vision, I definitely see my games all over the world.
Tal knows who can help.
Now we're going international, and Koret is helping us for the second time.
Look at these kids from Ashkelon, one of the most bombarded towns this summer. They literally spent 50 days running for shelters.
לא ראית פה רכב אחד. חודשיים. זה היה פשוט מדהים. האזעקות האלה הרגו אותם. הרגו אותם.
Moshe runs a small bus company. 15 buses, under 20 employees. He relied on tourism and busing kids all around this summer.
מכונות עמדו. לא נסענו לשום מקום. עמדנו במקום. וחיכינו שהמצב ישתפר. הקושי היה לגבי התשלום של המשכורות, שזה היה הצורך המיידי.
As part of Koret's expanding emergency loan program, his business loan was approved on the spot.
מילאנו תפסים וקיבלנו אישור בעקבות המצב, ובחר בחמש שעות אני עצמי הופתעתי מאוד מהמהירות שהכל התנהל בה. In the same day.
These are exactly the businesses that Koret is helping to help themselves.
This is, I call it a bistro pizza. We made the pizza that I believe that it's the best of this neighborhood.
Hadar started with Koret's help in Kiryat Gat, and now she's upgrading.
ההלוואה בא לי ממש בתקופה שחיפשתי מקורות אשראי. וההלוואה למעשה עזרה לי לממן את ההוצאות, גם את הזמן הזה שבעצם העסק לא פעל, וגם את עלויות השיפוט. This is my new place. אז כאן כרגע עובדים, אבל זה הולכת להיות הפיצריה שאני חלמתי עליה ושהיא תהיה מצליחה.
Koret has already provided 7,000 microfinancing loans to mostly Israeli women unable to obtain any form of business credit. This is especially significant in the Israeli Arab sector.
The Arab sector lives on small businesses because employment elsewhere is difficult. Historically, we've given over 500 loans, over 60 million shekels to this sector.
Meet Carl Kaplan, who left Wall Street 24 years ago to come to Israel. Carl is the founder and CEO of Koret for the past 20 years.
We're essentially making an investment in helping people help themselves, grow businesses, start businesses, create jobs, get people off welfare, increase taxes to the Israeli government, and grow the private sector as a whole. We've been in business for 20 years. We've helped almost 14,000 businesses in the country, created and supported 50,000 jobs, and managed the business in a very, very efficient way.
This hazardous waste management plant in Be'er Tuvia never closed during the war, and it wasn't easy.
Some of the women that lives in Ashkelon couldn't leave the kids because kids was not could not go to the kindergarten, so they had to stay with the kids. We kept on working. We didn't stop even for one day. Our customers didn't stop. All the industry in Israel didn't stop. We got used to it, let's say, okay?
Alex is now contemplating his move to a new site, also in the south.
2 years ago, we were 15 employees. Today, we are 32. This kind of activity is getting bigger and bigger all the time. We definitely know, I know already that in the new place, we are going to be at least 45 people. We bought a new place in Kiryat Gat, three times bigger than what we are here, and we were sure need more money for our development. I know that I will need more investment in the new place. I know that I will ask for the money from Koret.
In this village in southern Israel, Yaniv took unused family land and turned it into fruitful olive plantations, cashing in on Israel's culinary trend.
בעצם מהרגע שקטפת את הזית מהעץ, השמן בפנים מתחיל לאבד מהאיכות שלו. שמן עובר תהליכים של התחמצנות, הוא מאבד מהאיכויות שלו. אם הצלחנו להגיע עם חומר גלם טוב בעצם ליצור, אז כל מה שאנחנו צריכים לעשות זה רק לשמור עליו. זה זן שהוא דרך אגב פיתוח ישראלי.
On our special program to develop the Negev, we've given over 300 loans, approximately $30 million, 20% of which have been to agriculture. Many, many of the loans are to farmers who are exporting to Europe and other places in the world, and export, of course, is very important in terms of the overall economy in Israel.
We have here olive oil, olives, honey, spreads.
Koret helped Yaniv market his olive oil and other products all over Israel.
With the help of Koret, we bought machinery, also for picking the olives and also for treating the olive oil here.
And now he's preparing for the next move.
אנחנו הולכים לפתוח חנות במרכז קולינרי מאוד גדול, חדש, שהולך להיפתח בתל אביב. משהו שאנחנו מאמינים שיעזור לנו להתקדם עוד כמה שלבים קדימה. ואנחנו מקווים שבעזרת קרן קורת אנחנו נוכל להגיע באמת לחנות הזו ולכל מה שאנחנו מצפים שהיא תיתן לנו.
שלום, I'm Tal Kenan, chairman of Koret Israel Economic Development Funds. In an increasingly unstable region, Israel faces an array of pressing internal challenges. From establishing equal access to opportunity to reshaping our education system to produce 21st century leaders. Economic empowerment has been a critical tool in meeting these challenges. It multiplies our financial resources and, more importantly, ignites the flame of leadership in our communities. Our leveraged small business credit and microlending programs have sparked this flame. They're the most efficient deployment of development capital in Israel's economy. To date, KIEDF has facilitated over $320 million in business loans, creating or sustaining over 50,000 jobs, and forging a generation of leaders in Israel. Our work is really just beginning. We're still far from our potential. I welcome you to join us in bridging this gap and helping thousands of people shape their futures and our own. Thank you.
Thank you, Koret.
Thank you, Koret.
Koret, thank you.